Update for you on the next system eventually arriving here. Winter storm watches remain in effect statewide as we go from tomorrow afternoon through tomorrow night. There's a lot of moisture down to our south, which is mainly in the form of rain right now, continues to lift northward going forward. Kind of a seasonably chilly afternoon with a little bit of a breeze and a good deal of sunshine around, with temperatures in the 20s to lower range of the 30s. You will notice as we go through the evening, though, with clear skies and fairly light winds, we will fall below zero north of the notches, in the lower single digits to down to near zero in central parts of the state, and anywhere between the single digits to lower range of the teens in southeastern areas. Colder air that's in place as the clouds start to work their way in from the south tomorrow morning, out ahead of the next system, which will start arriving tomorrow afternoon. Notice temperatures in the low and mid 20s, maybe a few upper 20s in southeastern areas as this starts to move in. The arrival time really hasn't changed all that much. We're looking at sometime as early as noon, 1 o'clock in some southwestern areas, to later in the afternoon in the north country. You can notice by the time we get toward the evening commute, we're looking at the southern two-thirds of the state in the snow with temperatures in the 20s. This is likely going to make the roadways slick for the evening commute tomorrow, anywhere along and south of the White Mountains. We get later into the evening and the snow will continue to increase a bit in intensity. And then eventually after midnight, as the snow is falling everywhere across the state during the evening, you will notice a little bit of a mix starting to develop in southern areas of the state. This will likely be in the form initially of some sleet and may even change briefly to some freezing rain. While you will notice closer to the shoreline, there is even the potential with an onshore wind of a changeover along shore roads to plain rain. You will notice that sleet line continuing to try to navigate northward during the overnight hours. Maybe plain rain closer to the shoreline, or an icy mix with temperatures right around the freezing mark, while it continues to snow in the northern half of the state as we go through the overnight hours. This is likely when we wake up early Wednesday morning what storm tracker will look like. Temperatures in the 20s to lower range of the 30s. The north country will continue to see snow for the most part, may end as a brief mix early on Wednesday morning. It looks like it wraps up during the early to mid afternoon, while southern areas of the state may even see the sun come out late morning, early afternoon on Wednesday as any sort of precipitation wraps up. Yes, there could be a snow shower during the late afternoon or early evening hour Wednesday, but I do not suspect that will cause any additional issues to area roadways or any additional accumulation as well. Sunshine out there and a lighter breeze this afternoon. Temperatures are in the 20s. Tonight, again, colder air now in place later this evening, and even drier air, which does play a role in the forecast as the next system rolls in. Where it stays mostly, if not all, snow, the potential of over 6 inches of accumulation looking likely, maybe in upwards of 6 to 12 inches of snow, a possibility from the upper valley and lakes region, maybe even northern parts of the Monadnock region up through the Mount Washington Valley. And it does look like we'll even have that potential of around 10 or just more than that inches of snow in far northern areas of the state, with lesser amounts the theme here in southeastern areas. It's all really hingent on that line of either sleet and or freezing rain making its way into southern parts of the state after midnight. If it delays by several hours, it could mean several additional inches of snow before going over to a mix. So it looks like the evening commute tomorrow and the morning commute on Wednesday will be the most affected here for travel. Beyond that, it's quieter conditions Thursday and maybe a couple of mixed showers Friday.